I'm gonna have to stay still and vlog because the wind's doing my head in. And this episode's meant to be about reducing stress, and I'm already in a stressed state. Welcome to another episode of The Road to 2021. We are gonna be talking about stress and how to reduce it. What I like to do in the morning is try to limit screen time as much as possible. I find if I wake up, do my guided breathing, have a coffee, read, for the first half an hour, 45, you can limit being an Insta slave and being a, I don't know if I can say slave in 2019. I'll roll with it. Just a heads up, it's far too early for Christmas blend. Mid-November. When choosing a post-workout cereal, tend to keep fibre and fat relatively low. So opting for like a Curiously Cinnamon, Frosties, Crunchy Nut.
Rice Krispies, Cocoa Pops, okay, but then you've got to think about the volume. 100 grams of Crunchy Nut or Frosties compared to Rice Krispies. There you go.
I'm breaking every rule in the YouTube book. I'm sitting topless in an off season. But that's pretty much my morning routine in order to keep my stress levels as low as possible. Start the day with not too much stress. And then I do all my work after I've consumed food, and we'll go into that in the next episode in terms of digestion and about getting our heart rate and breathing into a good place to allow for optimal digestion before we consume meal number one. But that set up, wake up, water, guided breathing, book, go for my walk, clears the head a little bit, come back, and then we have meal number one. Time is now 11, same routine even though it's Saturday, no sort of differentiation between Saturdays and Sundays. My 7 day week is pretty much the same. We'll go to the gym about 1 o'clock today. Intro and pre-workout time, still using Strom's Carbomax. This, along with Demo Day, Axe and Sledge Demo Day by Seth Ferozzi, I would say, is up there with the two best intra-carbohydrates in terms of digestibility. So very, very good. Stacking that alongside the Pump Sports EAA. So 3,000 milligrams of leucine per 12. So I'll do like an 18-gram scoop to get myself around about 5,000 milligrams of leucine, and then using their pre-workout as well, which isn't too hefty on the caffeine side. You've got some other stimulants in there like hordenine, N-methyltyramine, huperzine. But what's nice when you have those ingredients in there that it's not too strong on the caffeine. Also in my intra is 5 grams of glycine, 5 grams of creatine monohydrate as well. And on my next order, I will purchase Dr. Dean's electrolytes. Because at the moment I'm just having a teaspoon of the 40,000 volts, which is okay, but in terms of the strength and the amount of electrolytes compared to each other, the supplement needs one is far superior. I always find it tricky as well matching a flavoured intra-workout, Carbomax's Mango, alongside an EAA, the Strawberry Kiwi and Carbomax Mango go very, very well together. That was one of the Q&A's today. What was the thoughts on Kanye's new album? I'm fucking with it. It's not too bad. There's a lot of that Sunday Service influence in there, but it's another piece in the Ye Empire, I suppose. Follow God sounds like his old stuff. But it'll have to be Kano on the way to the gym, because Kano's new album is superb. He's the bigger bastard man, but never fuck him off. Look, you can't fuck him off from me like a fucking arsehole, because I'm royal. Thank you. Tom, what has staying in the Shangri-La in London got to do with the video? I'm de-stressing. I've had a hectic month. I like to unwind and enjoy the fruits. Maybe even get a little massage. Hashtag gifted. I wish. No, I just... I decided they've got a scale. Just thought we'd go up here for the night. Enjoy a night, really. Getting Nando's. Chill out.
Click the tag. If you click the tag, you'd know. Aren't we getting so impatient as a society? Ending the video with supplementation. There's a reason behind that, and it's not... I didn't want to open the video and say, right, let's all start using blue light blocking glasses, taking ashwagandha and smoking CBD. And this can be linked back into sleep as well. Far too many of us are failing to understand the root cause and problems as to why we are feeling stressed and suffering from anxiety and have poor sleep, and are just masking it with supplementation. And I'm not for one sitting here saying I've got the cure for anxiety, but I'm hoping that certain individuals could have taken some pointers from this video, you know, the guided breathing in the mornings, the meditation, the not jumping on our phones too soon, little breaks away, a good me and Elle will go away once or twice every few months, and that's a nice little reset, you know, it sorts you out. But in front of me, we've got some blue light blocking glasses, which can probably be linked into the sleep episode that we're going to do. But I think it sits in both camps quite nicely, because when I do put the blue light blockers on, it signals that time to relax. And I put them on a couple of hours before I go to sleep. And obviously, because I'm still watching Netflix and the telly that emits blue light, and potentially that can impact on the secretion of melatonin as we sleep. Even though I'm quite dubious about blue light blockers, Steve Hall, Revive Stronger, did quite a good post on it, actually. And a lot of it is anecdotal. And if it works for you, then fantastic. When I put them on, it gives me that sort of, it's that lull. And I quite like them. They're relatively inexpensive, so worth putting in your stack, I suppose. And then we've got Support Max Neuro, a fantastic product that I will utilize around the training window as well. So post-workout, again, for the benefit of flipping the switch and getting into a parasympathetic state where we can ensure that digestion is as optimal as possible, but also from the point of view of using ashwagandha in there. And we can isolate it as well. We can take ashwagandha on its own. Insight Supplements sell it. I can't remember what brand it is, but we do sell it just completely on its own if you just wanted ashwagandha. But the systematic review that was done a few years ago, that was over a 4 or 5 week period, and there's a lot of beneficial research back in ashwagandha for alleviating stress and anxiety. If we looked at that systematic review where the scorecards were taken at the end of that 4 or 5 week period, and those that were taking ashwagandha compared to the placebo scored a lot higher, in the sense that they felt those reductions in stress and they felt those reductions in anxiety after taking it. So potentially look at including that in your supplement stack if you are suffering from that. And then we've got CBD as well, which probably deserves its own video, because it's gathered a lot of hype over this year, and particularly at the back end of last year. I don't use it as much as I used to, more so during deloads or like tail end of like quite an intense training block, for example. I'll start vaping it before bed. But generally, the factors that I can control in terms of reducing stress are enough for me not to warrant taking CBD. That's the only reason as to why I don't use it as frequent. I know a lot of people that rave about it and have had fantastic results from it, and especially those that aren't particularly even into the sort of bodybuilding and fitness world, just that are suffering from anxiety, that will take CBD and have profound, very beneficial effects on it. So again, a lot of the research that we see is very much anecdotal, and like I said, it probably deserves its own video. I think I've done a I don't know if I looked into many studies on it, but I've talked about CBD before. Anyway, I'm going to leave it there. They're just a few items that we can use, but more so, as I said at the start of this little clip here, let's try and understand the fundamental basics, the foundations to why we're feeling in a particular way before we throw supplements into the mix. Okay, I'm going to leave it there. I shall see you in the next video, which will either be the Q&A or the digestion one, or sleep. Who knows? Thanks for watching. I'll see you very soon. Thank you again, and much love.